news in English.
The British Ministry of Misinformation has been conducting a systematic campaign of frightening British women and girls about the danger of being injured by splinters from German bombs. The women have reacted to these suggestions and alarms by requesting their milliners to shape the spring and summer hats out of very thin tin plates, which is covered with silk, velvet, or other draping materials.
Everybody do the blackout stroll. Round about the town we'll all patrol. We can live as happily as old King Cole once we get together in the blackout stroll. What's the good of walking? We'll go round. Laugh away your worries like a clown. Very, very merrily we'll go to town. Happy and contented as the light go down. There's no more cuddling in the moonlight. No more pecking in the park. But why let's worry over moonlight? For when we're strolling in the dark, it's lovely. Everybody do the blackout stroll. Laugh and drive your tears right up the pole. Whisper, see you later to your baby doll. But now we change our partners in the blackout stroll. Everybody do the blackout stroll. Round about the town we'll all patrol. We can live as happily as old King Cole once we get together in the blackout stroll. What's the good of walking? We'll walk round. Laugh away the worries like a clown. Very, very merrily we'll go to town. Happy and contented as the lights go down. There's no more cuddling in the moonlight. There's no more pecking in the park. But violets worry over moonlight. For when we're strolling in the dark, it's lovely. Everybody do the blackout stroll. Laugh and drive your cares right up the pole. Whisper, see you later to your baby doll. And now we change your partners in the blackout stroll.
Manufacturers of certified Primo present for your pleasure and entertainment Bing Crosby, the Primo singer.
Oh,
here standing on the Franco-Belgian frontier, we're watching long columns of British troops and transports and supplies and guns coming through from France into Belgium. Just on this frontier, there's a little village which is presumably half French and half Belgian, since it stretches on both sides. And almost the entire village has turned out and seems to be standing in the street all day long watching these transports coming up. The welcome given by the Belgian people is really tremendous. But the enthusiasm of the people in this part of Belgium makes a sharp contrast with the sufferings of the refugees from such places as Liège. We saw several lorry loads of these unhappy people, and at one point on another road, we met a straggling little party of Belgians, old men and women and children, and some of them with rolled blankets tied over their shoulders, their few pathetic belongings strapped on their back or carried in cheap suitcases in their hands.
This is London calling in the overseas service of the BBC.
You will now hear a statement by the Prime Minister.
To speak to you for the first time as Prime Minister in a solemn hour for the life of our country, of our empire, of our allies, and above all, of the cause of freedom. A tremendous battle is raging in France and Flanders. The Germans, by a remarkable combination of air bombing and heavily armored tanks, have broken through the French defenses north of the Maginot Line, and strong columns of their armored vehicles are ravaging the open country, which for the first day or two was without defenders. This is one of the most awe-striking periods in the long history of France and Britain. It is also, beyond doubt, the most sublime. Side by side, unaided except by their kith and kin in the great dominions and by the wide empires which rest beneath their shields, side by side, the British and French people have advanced to rescue not only Europe, but mankind from the foulest and most soul-destroying tyranny which has ever darkened and stained the pages of history. Behind them, behind us, behind the armies and troops of Britain and France, gather a group of shattered states and bludgeon great races, the Czechs, the Poles, the Norwegians, the Danes, the Dutch, the Belgians, upon all of whom the long night of barbarism will descend, unbroken even by a star of hope, unless we conquer, and conquer we must.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you, no other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love, and with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to start a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire. And that one desire is you. And I know nobody else ain't gonna do it.